Solving puzzles like a Rubik's Cube may not be your greatest strength, but it's what this robot that I helped to build does best. Hi, I'm Richard, an engineer at Swinburne University, and this is Ruby, one of the world's fastest Rubik's Cube solving robots. Ruby was designed and built specifically to solve Rubik's Cubes. This puzzle has a possible 43 quintillion permutations, or ways to be messed up. And solving it, by getting all the same coloured squares back on the same face, presents a problem for many people. But not for Ruby. This robot not only solves Rubik's Cubes, but solves them in super fast time. Ruby has solved this puzzle in 8.9 seconds, which was close to a minute faster than the previous robot held record. It took about a year to design and build Ruby, and things didn't always go to plan. Want to know how Ruby solves a Rubik's Cube? Well, let me explain, step by step. Ruby starts by scanning all six sides of the cube with a webcam, and this visual information is sent to a computer. The computer uses color recognition software to map the location of the different colored squares on the cube. And then the computer spends about a thousandth of a second working out different ways to solve the puzzle before choosing the fastest one. Instructions on how to solve the puzzle are sent to the circuit board, which controls motors in each of the arms, and these in turn make the arms move. Each move involves gripping and turning a face of the cube either 90 or 180 degrees and takes just a fraction of a second. Now, since any cube can be solved in 20 moves or less, no matter how it's messed up, physically unscrambling one doesn't take Ruby long. But actually, it wasn't until really recently that robots beat humans at this game. Australian Felix Zemdegs is a super fast cube solver. He completed one in just 5.66 seconds. But records are made to be beaten, and our next robot, Ruby 2, is shaping up to be the fastest cube solver ever seen. It will be smaller, lighter, and hopefully much, much faster than Ruby, although it's a way off being functional right now. Building these robots has taught us heaps about robotics, software development, and engineering. But not necessarily how to solve these.